our PowerPoint. And just settle back. We will start with the prelude brought to us by Helen. Begin a new worship series today that we pray will be a breather and a sense of assurance to us all. Life is a series of exclamations from oh no, to hell, to oh yeah. We can swing between disappointment, helplessness, and gratitude on a daily basis. The Book of Psalms knows all about this. Written over a span of time from exile and isolation to the rebuilding of the community, the poetry of the Psalms will accompany us in this series, reminding us that through it all, we can trust that God is indeed holding our lives. So I invite you to take a deep breath as we step into worship this morning. We do not live in a land ruled by king, as the hearers of our first psalm of this series did. Nevertheless, the petitions of the psalmist for justice, deliverance, defense of the poor and oppressed, and peace for all peoples is an undergirding theme of our faith. We are reminded that a just society is one that proclaims these lives are precious and worthy of protection. God, indeed, is holding our lives. Let this be our epiphany in this new year. Join with me in the responsive opening collect. And again, I invite people to mute if you are not muted. Holy and just God, you have shown us what is right and good. Open us this day to a vision of the world made all right, so that we might follow your ways and know the peace of your reign on earth as it is in heaven. We praise you for your steadfast presence, holding our lives together in love. Amen. And now I would invite our reader. We are hearing from the Luke and Psalter translation, our Psalms for this period. And I've just completely lost who our reader is this morning.
Alvitters.
Alvitters.
There we go.
Oh God. Oh God. Give your anointing to judgment and your justice. Teach your servants to govern your people rightly and bring justice to the oppressed. The mountains will bring the people peace, and the little hills justice. Your anointing and the oppressed among the people. Save the children of earth and crush the oppressed. The reign of your anointing will endure. Is the sun throughout all the rule of the church will be like light coming down on earth, like showers watering the earth. Justice will flower and abundance till the moon shall be no more. Tarshish and the isles will offer gifts. Arabia will bring all rulers to pay homage, and all the nations will serve your anointing will rescue the poor when they cry out, and the oppressed when there is to help them. Your chosen will take pity on the lowly and the poor, and will save their souls. Your chosen will rescue and oppression, and will treat the blood as precious.
Amen. Thank you, Al. In this series, we have a guest composer. Richard Bruxfort Colligan is a modern-day interpreter of the Psalms, a psalmist. In our theme song, written by Richard, God is Holding Your Life, his songs have easy to sing choruses that help bring the seminal message into our voices and hearts. In this psalm song coming up, the chorus is, "These lives are precious. These lives are precious. We know. You'll catch on quick. Here is an introduction from Richard and his song interpretation.
Hi, friends. It's Richard. I want to invite you into a song for Psalm 72. Psalm 72 is an interesting one. It seems like back in the day, this song was written as a coronation hymn, a blessing for a king. The leader that they are singing about, that they're asking God to bless, was a remarkable person. Listen to this. This king was compassionate and generous and always looking for justice for his people. This person paid attention to the poor, it says, the lowly, those living with violence. This king paid attention to the most vulnerable in society. Psalm 72 invites us to think about who is most vulnerable in our society right now, in the world, in your neighborhood, in your circle of friends, or in your family. Who is most vulnerable? And what would it be like to be as compassionate and generous as this king? The text says, you are like rain showering down on the farmland, so that up in the mountains where the fields grow, food will come up. That food is justice for everyone. This song is called These Lives Are Precious, and it comes from a line, where is it here? That says, the king redeems their lives from oppression and violence. Their blood is precious in his eyes. The most vulnerable of us, we can say, these lives are precious.
You're the goodness raining on the farmland. Your peace sprouting in the mountain fields. You're a harvest of the love and justice, ripening to feed and heal. These lives are precious. These lives are precious, you know. These lives are precious. Oh, these lives are precious, you know.
And so this season, this month, we're focusing on the Psalms and on our connection to God and to the people around us, what God's connection with us means for us and how we live. This psalm was written to be repeated at a coronation, and it lifts up the attributes of a just and right king. At a coronation, you're not quite sure what you're getting into. You think you know, the same as we think we know what we're getting into with a new president come January 20th. We think we know, but we also know what we are aspiring for and what we're praying for. And so that should be part of our daily life, is praying for our leaders, praying for our new leaders, as well as those that have been in office, praying that God will help them to be just and righteous, that God will help them to be compassionate, to remember and care for all of the people that God has placed in their jurisdiction. Goodness begets more goodness, we're told. And I think that we see that. We certainly see it in our entertainment and in our movies, that when we see the hero doing good, even when they're stepped on, there's a piece of us that says, I want to be like that. I want to be brave. I want to care for other people more than I care for myself. I want to be that better person. And we say this to ourselves all the time, don't we? The reverse is true also, that if we have a leader that is harsh, if we have a leader that teaches us fear and teaches us to close off others, that we start to emulate that also. And so as Christ followers, we need in this season to remind ourselves to pray for our leaders, that they will help us to become better than we are, that they will help us to look beyond ourselves, that they will help us to be the best that we can be. The video features images of tender plants that need water and sun to grow, and tells us that all lives are precious and precarious and in need of tender care. How will we live that out this year? Whenever there are necks stepped upon, physically, economically, or socially, the whole of society suffers. How will we protect those precious lives this year? With our words, with our deeds, with our prayers, wherever we find ourselves, in whatever way we can, how will we protect the lives that God has placed in this world? Let us pray for a rule of the land that honors each precious life. And may we know that we are loved and called to love in extraordinary ways. Amen. And so this season, I'm reaching out to you folks. Make a video or send an email or a written letter, three sentences on how you have felt the love and support of others and of God in this time of pandemic. So just three sentences. We're going to collect these, and some of them will be shared during worship. Just a short piece. How have you felt the love of God? How have you felt the love of others during this time, the support? And Let me start our screen share again. And I am going to back us to that slide. So part of this series, we will, let me back that up. The Psalms have a repeated direction throughout, the word Selah. Scholars are not exactly sure what this means. Perhaps because the Psalms were used in worship, we can surmise that the word indicates a pause or an invitation for a musical instrument to be played. In this worship series, we will use an instrumental sound to remind us to take a pause, a breath, and remember that the settling of our hearts can offer the feeling that we are held in the hands of the divine. We will hear, and then have some silence. Feel free to close your eyes if you like. Imagine yourself held in safety and love and care. When you hear again, then open your eyes and be present once more in community. And so I invite you into that silence. Each week, we will have a moment to write prayer concerns on small pieces of paper. So if you have a pen and paper, you're invited to write down your prayer concerns and then place those concerns in a bowl, a container, a box. If you have something present, if not, just place it on the table before you. If you don't have a pen and paper, think of your prayer concerns and imagine them being placed before you. It's a symbolic action of placing them in God's hands, God's care. Too often we hold on to our concerns. We offer them to God and immediately take them back. So I invite you to take that moment, write down your concern. Place it before God. Now let the people say, Selah. I invite you to unmute and we will continue our prayers. The way we will pray for this season is I will offer a category of concern. And I'm going to back us up there. I will offer a category of concern and I'll allow a brief pause where you may raise in silence or aloud those names that come to mind in that category. So listen closely to the categories so that you can raise appropriate prayers for each one. Then we will respond as indicated. As a prayer posture for this worship series, I invite you to cup your hands ready to receive God's love and peace. And in preparation to be God's love and peace in this world. And so let us pray for the leaders of this world and this church community. We pray for Donald Trump in his last few weeks.
Joe Biden.
or Bishop Bickerton.
For the vaccine to help the people.
Pray for Anna.
For Pastor Betty and all of those that help our church to work.
To a friend that has Alzheimer's.
God of justice, hear our prayer. Let us pray for those who live in conflict around the world.
And please hear our prayer.
Pray for those in India and Sri Lanka. Prince of Peace, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all who are experiencing loss of any kind in this pandemic.
Come, healer, hear our prayer.
For those who have lost loved ones. For those who are out of work.
Pray for Miles. Pray for Christian.
Pray for a friend that has cancer.
Comforting healer. Hear our prayer. Let us pray for those who are homeless, hungry, and alone.
God bless us.
For those who are in shelters. For those who are on the street.
Melissa.
Line up at
those who are in the street.
Emmanuel, God with us, hear our prayer. Let us pray for those who live in comfort, for Christ-like hospitality and generosity.
Transform in spirit. Hear our prayer.
For the wealthy.
Pray for Josephine.
Mother, be with Christmas.
Transforming spirit. Hear our prayer. Holy and living one, for those we have named and the ones whose names we do not know.
Hear our prayer.
We continue in prayer, praying as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen.
And now we have our offering of special music, if Glenn will, he's coming in from the other side. Charlie Galante has been using our sanctuary to make recordings for a class. He is a student at Yale. We give him, and you can adjust this, however, whatever is gonna help you. There we go. He is a student at Yale, so we are very thankful, and I am going to stop the share so that you can see him a little more clearly with any luck. And in fact, I'm gonna let him see himself. There you go. Thank you, Charlie.
Hi, everyone. I'm so happy to be here. I'm just gonna play the Adagio from Bach's Third Gamba Sonata. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Come back in. Yes. I am thankful for Charlie's gift and reminded of what the world would be if we would live into the best of who we are, rather than so often the worst of who we are. Amen. Thank you, Charlie. Thank you so much. It is customary for United Methodists on the first Sunday of the year or the last Sunday of the year to refer back to our roots. In 1775, John Wesley introduced a covenant service as an important part of spiritual life in the Methodist societies. They practiced this at least once a year, and I saw that flip by. Thank you, Kathy, because she has reminded me that we are indeed, should come to offering before we offer our lives in the covenant prayer. Let us offer out of all of the rest of who we are. So if you have sent in something, that's wonderful. If you haven't and you have it in front of you, that's great. Beyond your material wealth, I invite you to look into your heart in this moment, to look and see what it is that you would offer to your God, and to hold that in front of you as we pray. Gracious and loving God, we stand before you with our gifts, our tithes, our offerings. We pray that you will receive them, that you will bless them, that you will use all that we bring to spread your realm, your hope, your love here in this community, in this country, and throughout the world. We pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And so now, in the same spirit, I invite you into this time of making our covenant. And so if you can, you may want to kneel or bow in front of God. If you physically cannot, place yourself in the sense of kneeling or bowing as we pray together. O righteous God, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, see me as I fall down before you. Forgive my unfaithfulness in not having done your will, for you have promised mercy to me if I turn to you with my whole heart. God requires that you shall put away your idols. I hear from the bottom of my heart, renounce them all, covenanting with you that no known sin shall be allowed in my life. Against your will, I have turned my love toward the world. In your power, I will watch all temptations that will lead me away from you. For my own righteousness is riddled with sin, unable to stand before you. Through Christ, God has offered to be your God again, if you would let him. Before all heaven and earth, I acknowledge you as my Lord and God. I take you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for my portion, and vow to give up myself, body and soul, as your servant, to serve you in holiness and righteousness all the days of my life. God has given the Lord Jesus Christ as the only way and means of coming to God. Jesus, I do here on bended knees accept Christ as the only new and living way, and sincerely join myself in a covenant with him. O blessed Jesus, I come to you hungry, sinful, miserable, blind, and naked, unworthy even to wash the feet of your servants. Are you here with all my power, except you as my Lord and head? I renounce my own worthiness and vow that you are the Lord, my righteousness. I renounce my own wisdom and take you for my only guide. I renounce my own will and take your will as my law. Christ has told you that you must suffer with him. I do here covenant with you, O Christ, to take my lot with you as it may fall. Through your grace, I promise that neither life nor death shall part me from you. God has given holy laws as the rule of your life. I do here willingly put my neck under your yoke to carry your burden. All your laws are holy, just, and good. I therefore take them as the rule for my words, thoughts, and actions, promising that I will strive to order my whole life according to your direction, and not allow myself to neglect anything I know to be my duty. The Almighty God searches and knows your heart. O God, you know that I make this covenant with you today without guile or reservation. If any falsehood should be in it, guide me and help me to set it aright. And now glory be to you, O God the Father, whom I from this day forward shall look upon as my God and Father. Glory be to you, O God the Son, who has loved me and washed me from my sins in your own blood, and now is my Savior and Redeemer. Glory be to you, O God, the Holy Spirit, who by your almighty power have turned my heart from sin to God. O mighty God, the Lord omnipotent, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you have now become my covenant friend, and I, through your infinite grace, have become your covenant servant. So be it, and let the covenant I have made on earth be ratified in heaven. Amen. And so you are advised to make this covenant not only in your heart, but in word, not only in word, but in writing. Therefore, with all reverence, lay the service before the Lord as your act and deed. And when you have done this, sign it. Then keep it as a reminder of this holy agreement between God and you, that you may remember it during doubts and temptations. Amen. And now, in the knowledge that God is holding your life even as we hold each other, you are not alone. You are loved. Go in peace. Amen. We come to our postlude, and then you can stay on for credits and for saying goodbye. Thank you. Amen. Amen. We have one more credit slide, and then we can come out of this, and you can see each other again. There we go.
Yes.
There you go. Amen. So thank you all for coming and worshiping this day.
And thank you, Pastor, for another good sermon. And I say Happy New Year, safe. Everybody stay safe. God bless and love you all.
Take care, Betty.
Okay, take care.
Thanks, Betty.
Bye-bye.